Hi, I'm Attorney Badette, and welcome back to my channel. Happy to be back here in Bicol. I really, really miss this place, and for those who don't know me, I'm a proud Bicolana. I graduated from the University of Santo Tomas, Legazpi. Here's my dog, Saji, and she will be joining our vlog today. Today, we will be talking about something very relevant. Right now, we are going through so much as a country and as a nation. Because of the pandemic, everything has been shifted online, including classes. I know this is all new to you. Personally, I have not experienced anything like this in my life. Libraries are closed, cafes are closed, and I know it's a struggle for students who have been used to studying outside. So today, we will be talking about something that we need to do to cope up with the situation. How do you study during pandemic, and how do you prepare for your online classes? First step is to find a comfortable place in your house to study. I know this may seem easy, pero actually mahirap ito. There are a lot of distractions in your house. It may be your siblings, your mom, or your dad, or even your pet dog. Maraming ingay sa loob ng bahay. Your study place must allow you to focus and must give you complete silence. This used to be my study table when I was in law school. I don't know about you, but personally, when I was reviewing for the bar, I really had to, you know, find a place that had complete silence kasi I really cannot study with the noise all around. Kahit yung patak ng tubig sa gripo na rininig ko. Pero iba-iba naman tayo eh. So it's up to you on how you can find a place. It may be a chair, it may be a small table in your house or a sofa, anywhere in your home, as long as you are comfortable with it. Second, prepare your schedule. I know I have mentioned this in my past videos and even with my interview with Attorney Diane, who is our bar top notch. You must have your schedule. Your schedule doesn't have to be monthly. It can be weekly or on a daily basis. Write down what you will study in the morning and what you will study in the afternoon. For those working students who are in a work from home situation, I think you can use this to your advantage. Ito na ang tamang parahon para maghabol ng readings. Take this opportunity to read what you have not read and to cover those topics that you have not given so much time before. Next is, know your coverage. Tingnan nyo kung gaano ba kahaba ang inyong babasahin para malaman nyo kung paano nyo imamanage yung time. Look at the codal provisions or scan the pages of the annotated book. Gaano ba kakapal yung sa babasahin ninyo and how many hours would that take for you to finish your coverage? For first year law students or those who have been just starting out their law school journey, my advice here is please, please, please do not skip your annotated book. I'm not saying that using a reviewer is bad. I'm just saying na since you are just starting, it's best for you to really have that in-depth understanding of the law. And your annotated books will help you. After reading your annotated books and then you want to memorize, then your reviewers can help you. For those naman who will be studying for a very long coverage, my advice to you is to study smart. I know the reality is at times you really cannot finish the entire coverage. That's the case, you have to prioritize which one of these topics is the most important. And if the coverage is very long, chances are only the most important topics will be discussed by your professor and only those very important questions will be asked in your recitation. So take the tip, study smart. And one of the most important things is discipline. Dahil nasa bahay tayo, we think we are very free to do whatever we want. Nandiyan ang bed, nandiyan ang TV, nandiyan ang Wi-Fi, even your social media, in your phones, in your laptops, and it would be a challenge. So you must discipline yourself na you have to take time off of these things. Stay away from your phone because that is your number one distraction. Discipline yourself and focus na this is what I have to do and this is what I have to finish. After studying for some hours, take a break for 10 to 15 minutes. This will help you relax and makakawala din ito ng antok. Lalo pa kung ilang oras ka na nagbabasa, you are getting sleepy. You may have a snack or you may have something to bite on. And also taking a break helps your mind. Once you take a break and you come back, the mind absorbs things much better. So don't forget to take a break. After you have studied the entire morning or after you have studied the entire afternoon, here is what you do. You take a silent moment and assess yourself. Try to remember all the things you have studied. Na-absorb mo ba yung binasa mo? Kasi sometimes we have given so many hours for studying but we did not absorb what we have read. This is an advice that has been given to us during our bar review. It is not the quantity of the readings you've had. It's the quality of your readings. So assess yourself. Ano ba yung na-absorb mo talaga? Ano ba yung natutunan mo? After evaluating yourself, you realize na 10 to 30% lang yung naintindihan mo sa binasa mo. And you have the time, go back to it. Go back to what you have studied for the day. If it helps you to read it 2-3 times, if you have the time, then why not? You have to understand what you have read for you to be able to recall it. One final thing and one of the most difficult things to do right now is to focus. We are distracted by so many things in life, sa lahat ng mga nangyayaring kaguluhan sa mundo, sa ating gobyerno, na at times na we get distracted and we're not thinking clearly. Let's find a way to adapt. And by adapting means doing our best to cope up with what is happening. I know it's hard not to see your professors live. Honestly, if I were in your situation, it would be really hard for me because I'm a very visual person. But you have to make most of what you have right now. And that is time. Read, memorize, and know the law. Because there is no better way to be prepared than to study. So that's it for today, guys. I hope I was helpful to you. If you have any questions or suggestions, you may comment down below. And if you have topics that you want us to discuss, you can also suggest that in the comment box. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and you can do it, future attorneys.